vlog clip Monday. My ass is kicked. I'm exhausted. I've been working on this all day in the absolute worst part of a car to work on. The pedals. Pedals look way better. That's right. We got those suckers in. The clutch, the whole problems with the clutch pedal, I mean, the brake pedal's not a lot better, but the big problems with the clutch pedal, the back side of the clutch pedal is tapered like this. So as you drill a hole to put the stud through, the screw through, the screw's not long enough, the nut goes into it, goes sideways because of the taper, and then won't tighten. This is what CAD is for. I do not understand how BMW can make and sell products that don't fit. Anyways, I used a file and a drill and got them sanded down enough that the nut's threaded. Then the brake pedal, that's solid metal. And drilling through that's a bitch, especially with crap drill bits. So those are in. The throttle pedal is easy. It's just plastic and the screws just thread into it, and then it's even got adhesive on it, and that's done. So when I'm done pulling the carpet in and out every 10 minutes, I will be able to put the throttle back in. I also did the clutch position sensor today. Let me turn on the light and I'll show you. Okay, there's four pins on the clutch position sensor. It is there. There's the four wires going to it. That's heat shrunk, whatever, terminal connectors. Three of the wires go into the CAS, which is the general module, and that's up there. This is all about as neat as I can possibly do it. These things would be watertight, even though they don't look pretty. Three of the wires are there. The fourth is a ground. I followed the wires down here. I found the grounds. Grounds go into this grounding block bolted to the chassis under the carpeting. So I dug out the E39 wiring harness from a car I've dismantled and took that apart, pulled out one of the pins from the E39 and slid it in here. So this wire, I believe, right here is actually out of an E39 M5, but it's grounded into the E60 M5 ground block. And then spliced or crimped into a black wire that runs up there with the aftermarket, or the facelift rather, LCI taillight wires up to here, back down there. I left myself plenty of extra wire, and there is the clutch position sensor. So that's done, and the pedals are done, and a couple other errands, and that took all day.
Hello and good evening. It was pizza night for me here at the house. I put that away and then crashed on the couch for a little bit. So as I mentioned today, we got the clutch position sensor done. We got the pedals put on. And then we have to block off the cooling lines that on the E90 M3, that transmission, would have gone up from the transmission up over the bell housing through the engine bay and out to a transmission oil radiator out in the front bumper somewhere. The E60 M5 doesn't have and doesn't need such a system. So I looked up the lines that we could buy and then either cut and just weld them together or cap them or run a hose between them or whatever. I looked those up online. They're gonna be about $600, $550 or so for a set, which is crazy for something that you're gonna mutilate as soon as you get it. So I went on eBay. There were two sets on eBay, one in Australia and one in South Carolina. So I got the set in South Carolina. They delivered late last week. And then today we cut off the transmission side fittings, took them over to a few transmission shops in Escondido until we found somebody who cut them at a kind of a proper location. And then the guy just said, you don't need, this is not a pressure, this is not a line that has to deal with pressure, and it's not a line that is even below the oil level. So he just gave us a piece of fuel hose and said, just run this between them and put some aircraft clamps on the end of them, some hose clamps on the end of them, and tighten it down and you're good. And I'm thinking like, that's true. It's not high pressure, it's not going to have a lot of fluid in it. A rubber hose isn't the end of the world. So I come home and I test fit it, and then I notice that it's about 4.5 inches away from a catalytic converter. Cats get really hot, especially on a 5-liter V10. So that's not going to work. We need a metal fitting. No, I don't want any rubber components here outside of the O-rings that are inside the transmission. So tomorrow, we're going to take the lines to a different shop, see if they can just weld some caps on them, just close them off using metallic components. So some progress there. Once that's done, we can bolt those in place. We can finalize bolting the transmission up to the chassis. We can put the brace in, torque everything to spec, put the shifter through the hole, back into the shifter carrier in the chassis, shifter grommet, shifter sound insulation. We could probably reassemble the majority of the center console. We can actually make a lot of progress once that part's done. But another complication is the two hoses go into the side of the transmission, then they've got this little bracket similar to how the power steering hoses go into the front power steering cooler on an E39. And there's a bolt that goes in there and tightens down the little bracket that then holds the two lines into the transmission. So we didn't get the bolt with the kit. I looked up the part number. We went to BMW Escondido. There's none in the United States. The nearest one is in Germany, and it's 3 weeks out. It's $3. So we gotta wait 3 weeks for this bolt to come in. However, if it's like any of the other things that we've ordered from Germany, it'll come a lot faster than that. We've heard 3 weeks, 4 weeks, and they show up in like 10 days, so we'll see. That's the update on the car. That was pretty much the majority of the day. I went through some mail tonight, I had dinner, watched some YouTube, and now we're going to bed. I will talk to you guys on Wednesday. Good night.